Good evening friends, this is Pradeep Kumar here. Today we are going to see how to install Aqua Simulator in Network Simulator 3. Actually, the history behind Aqua Simulator is it was launched, it was developed by a researcher mainly for NS2, mainly for underwater sensor networks. It was having a 3D model as well as a two-dimensional model both. So after for 10 years or so, there was no support from AquaSim because of the change in operating systems like Ubuntu, Linux Mint and Fedora. AquaSim was not supported in all these operating systems, so it was a tedious process to customize AquaSim for NS2. Also the three-dimensional AquaSim is still more tougher to deal with it. So now recently a professor called us Martin, a PhD student. He has done the AquaSim, he is maintaining the AquaSim new next generation for NS3, since NS3 is picking up in the market. So AquaSim NG has been very popular in installing under NS3. The main advantage is it supports a 3-dimensional model, 2-dimensional model and various medium access control, vector based forward algorithms, and there are so many algorithms and protocols, architectures available for AquaSimulator. Now in this post, what we are going to see is we'll be seeing how to install this Aqua Simulator in Network Simulator 3. So here comes to the instruction. So installation of Aqua Sim in NS3. This is what our topic is all about. So the first thing and foremost thing is before we install Aqua Sim, we should have installed NS3 already in our package. And you can refer my website nsnam.com for installing NS3 in Ubuntu 16.04. I used here Linux Mint 18.1, so which is developed from Ubuntu 16.04, the same repository it uses. So the same whatever instruction I am telling you here will be working out very well for Ubuntu 16.04. Okay, so coming to this point, I assume that NS3 is already installed. NS3 is installed already, and now we are going for additional instructions. So the very first instruction is, so I am using the OS is Linux Mint 18.1, then NS3 version is NS-3.27. So I am using the version NS-3.27, so that the AquaSim NG was tested in NS-3.24, 25, 26 and 27. So now the recent version of NS3 is NS3.28, which was not tested, but it still works fine. As I have already tried, it still works fine. So let us go to the instructions of how to install this AquaSim. So I have a folder available, NS-SolidMon-3.27, then CD-NS-3.27 and CD-SRC. So this is the place that I will be going. So what you do is you can execute this command like this. So I'll just give the instructions on how to use these commands. Assume I have installed NS3 in my home folder. So in the home folder, you need to give this command: NS-SolidMon-3.27/NS-3.27/SRC. Because we need to download the AquaSim package into the source folder and then we have to compile it. So for downloading this source code from the website, either we can use the GitHub website through cloning, or we can download and then extract it. So there are two methods, but GitHub seems to be the better option, as the folder name, folder structure, everything will be as per their design. It will be installing successfully, but I have tried with the separate download. So you need to rename the folder according to the specification what they have mentioned. Accordingly, the AquaSim will work. Yes, now the instruction for this will be, so we have to use git clone. So already we have installed the software git software through the repository using sudo apt space install space git git, already tried. Now I'll be using a URL here, so you can see https://github.com/r-martin-5-aquasim-ng.git. so this is the command. So you can access all these commands in the YouTube channel itself. I'll give you, so git clone, then this command. So once you give this command here, this will be downloading or the cloning the AquaSim directly from that website to our folder here. Okay, done. So when you check it here, so we have seen that we can see that there is a folder called as aquasim. You can see that aqua-sim-ng. So it is mandatory to mention the folder name like this, aqua-sim-ng. I have tried with simply with aquasim without any gap between them, and I have tried with aquasim-ng-master as the download says that. I was getting some installation error when I was installing this. So better you try to have this, keep this name into it. So that's what the second command. So after it is added to the source, we have to run it. So to run this, what we have to do is, so to install this, first we have to come out of the source directory. So I'll be coming here now. So I am in the directory ns3.27. So here this is the command /wav. So enable -examples enable -test configure. So we have to give this command. So we will just copy this command and I will be giving it, pasting it here. So first thing is you have to come out of this and then use this command. So this is the command. So let's see if this command works or not. Sometimes this command might throw an error because it may be giving an error in Python. So then after that we'll give this command wav. So this command is /wav, next command. So you can see that the aquasim models are being compiled here. So there are 2705 packages. So if you have installed NS3 already, so the time taken will be very less. But if you are installing NS3 for the first time along with aquasim, then it will be taking some more time to get it installed. So you may be getting an error sometimes, so because of some Python binding error. If you get any error on Python bindings, so what you can do is in this same command you can use disable Python, disable -python. You can use this command. So along with the wav, enable example, enable test configure, you can disable Python here. So this is to indicate that there is no Python binding needed for compiling aquasim-ng. So you can disable it. So in my case, I think so far I didn't get any errors, but if I encounter any error, then I need to give the command again here, /wav configure disable Python with the examples enablement and the test enablement. So let's wait for another 2 minutes so that the software will be installed successfully. Yes, now you can see the modules built here. So I'll just maximize this window here. When the modules are built, you can check it here. Aquasim-ng has also built successfully. So that indicates that Aquasim-ng module has been built successfully. And if you want to run any examples over there, so you can, what you can do is you can go to the source, you can go to aquasim folder, and you can go to examples. So there you can able to see there are so many examples, bmac.cc, ddos.cc, flood test, gold string, broadcast mac example like that. So you can able to run so many examples here. So these examples you can able to run by bringing it to the scratch folder, and then you can start running. So let me give a small example here. So what I do is I do an example wav --run. Broadcast mac underscore example. So what I do is I'll bring the broadcast mac example into the scratch folder. So what I do is I'll just go to src, then I go to aquasim. Then I go to examples. So here I will be copying this broadcast example. So broadcast mac and example.cc to previous folder scratch. So what I did is I just copy the file using the command cp. I'm in the examples directory here. So I'll just use this command here. So cp broadcast mac example.cc, go to the corresponding folder where this file is located, and then go to the previous directory, one more directory, inside that we have a scratch folder. So in the scratch folder you copy this. So after you copy this, you just come to the NS3.27 folder. So this is the location where I will be running it. So what I do is WAF --run scratch broadcast Mac underscore example. So since for running the C++ file, you did not specify any extension here, so we are not specifying anything, and then I'll be running it here. So this is the first example that Aquasim uses here. So you can see this here, how many nodes have been created. There are these many nodes with the position is been created, and this is a simple simulation. So complicated simulations like how to see the three dimensional, because Aquasim uses underwater sensor networks, wherein in the underwater sensor, when the sensors are thrown into the water, so they will form a three dimensional mapping where the nodes may not sink to the ground, but it will be floating. So during floating also, it will be trying to send the packets, and we should have a supporting medium access control. And the first and foremost thing is a broadcast, because all the nodes in the water, they broadcast themselves to form the network first. So this example shows the broadcast Mac example for Aquasim, particularly for underwater sensor networks. Okay, so this is the basic introduction of how to install Aquasim in NS3. So this video I recorded mainly for the purpose of my students, that some of them are doing their work on underwater sensors. The first and foremost difficulty is to how to install this software in Linux, particularly in NS3. So that's why this is there. So maybe subsequently I'll give you some more examples on how to use Aquasim examples and how to predict the performance characteristics of underwater sensor networks. So thank you. So if you want to help me out, so you can subscribe to my channel. So I have a channel here in youtube.com/tspradeepkumar. Also refer my website http://nsnam.com. So please join my website as well as subscribe to my channel. So thanks for listening. Thank you.